Today's stream is dedicated to Herb Zettel and all he has done for BECA Department. Good afternoon and welcome to BECA Sports Network. We are live at the Swamp at Cox Stadium here at San Francisco State University. The California State University Bay Sea Otters women's soccer team have traveled to SFSU to battle the Gators in the last game of the regular season in the CCAA Division II matchup. I'm Efren Luna, and joining me today is my broadcast partner, Brandon Rivera. This is the second time these teams faced off this season, with the last matchup ending in a draw 1-1 on September 23rd at the Otter Sports Complex Soccer Field in Seaside, California.
All right, and the ball is ready to roll. It looks like San Francisco State has the ball here, going back here, going back and forth. Friend, both teams are... both teams coming in with not many wins. Both teams are kind of in the bottom here of the CCAA. How do you think today's going to go?
I think today's going to be a close matchup. As we know, when they formally met on the 23rd of September, it was a draw, 1-1. I think today's key is going to be who can hold on to possession more and be more comfortable in the final thirds of each half, of each team's half.
Yeah, both San Francisco's coming in with a 3-12-2 record, and Monterey Bay's coming with a 3-8-5 record in the CCA. Fun story: Monterey Bay haven't won a game away, so we'll see if that's going to change today. But we'll see if San Francisco is going to keep that zero on that win mark. So, do you think they'll be able to do so?
I think it's going to be tough because the Gators are going to look to end off the season really strong at Cox Stadium here at the Swamp. And here we see We see the Gators putting pressure in the front.
It looks like we got the Gators up here on the far left on the wing here trying to get a school.
That's amazing hustle right there by the forward of SF Gators.
Looks like we got a corner kick here for the Gators. Gators here. They've had 41 corners overall in the season, but they've given up 82 overall. So we got a corner here trying to go down the middle. And it looks like Monterey Bay gets it, trying to get it out going here. Looks like number 14 is trying to get it, but it's out of bounds.
San Francisco is doing a good job of coming out strong and hustling for them balls starting out the game as we win a header right there.
Looks like we got the captain here. Looks like going to the number 31, trying to get it to the right-hand side on the wing. Number 31 here.
Samantha Shim.
Yeah. From Cypress, California. She's trying to midfielder here, trying to get something going for the Gators.
Alexa fighting, showing good grit in the final third.
Looks like it's out of bounds. Looks like it's going to be Otter ball here. Another throw in.
Right off the bat, we can see San Francisco State coming in with a lot of pressure. And I think that's going to be a big factor in who comes out on top today.
Yeah, same here. Looks like for San Francisco, the player we should be looking out for is Carissa Campinpin, midfielder junior. She's tied with the lead with 2 goals with 17 games played and 15 games started. And on the Otter side, player we should watch out for is Amelia McManus, forward junior, 16 games played, 16 games started. She has 7 goals and 1 assist for the season, 29 shots and 17 shots on goal with 1 game winner here. How do you think the Gators are going to respond here to try to stop her?
I think, once again, going back to putting high pressure and high hustle into each of the 50-50 balls, that's going to be a big indicator of who's going to come out on top in this game.
Looks like the Otters going back. Oh, look, but it looks like it loses it to number 31, Samantha Shin here, trying to get something going here. This is back to number 29 of the Otters, Cameron Burbank. She's a midfielder from Vacaville, California. Looks like it's throwing from the Gators, number 5 here, going in, the captain, Carissa Campinpin, trying to get down the middle, but send out. Looks like the Otter balls are trying to get in the left wing side here.
Monterey Bay, this is going to be their first chance at the final third of San Francisco. And it looks like it's going to be an offside.
Okay, it looks like got off sides here by the official. Looks like Gator ball back. How do you think the Gators should involve Carissa Campinpin here? Just try to get her to score. Do you think they want to get her back down the middle or go from there?
I think it's gonna have to be a lot of first time shots from Carissa. That's gonna be the way to go about it, is catch the keeper off guard with a one touch shot. As we were seeing the warm ups going, the keeper did look very strong for the Otters, but I think that's gonna be a factor, is catching the keeper by surprise.
All right, looks like the throw in here from number 14, another foul.
And you can see the Otters are getting a little bit more energy and picking up the pressure that they're putting on the defense.
Yeah, very aggressive right now. It looks like we got a kick here. Kick it down again to the right-hand side, back to an Otter ball. And number 5 here, Campinpin here. Looks like they're going here, going down to Samantha. Number 11 trying to get down the middle. And looks like he lost it back to the Otters here. Otter trying to get back to the right-hand side, back to the Gators here. But Otters try to get it back here.
I must say the Gators are doing a good job of keeping their shape when the Otters do have the ball and shifting in their positions. You can see they're very well organized in their formation starting the half.
Yeah, I don't think the records really speak to how good these both teams are. Even though both teams only have three wins for the season, they're pretty resilient with each other, against each other. Looks like we're going out right here on the right-hand wing, trying to get it down the center, but it's loses possession.
What a clearance! What a clearance by a defender.
The Gator show. Oh. Looks like it's almost a mistake here by the goalie, but goalie kind of saves yourself.
See, in those moments, San Francisco needs to take advantage of those mistakes, because I'm not sure if the Otters are going to be making too many mistakes. But San Francisco is going to have to capitalize.
And any little things for from the Otters? Yeah, almost a mistake here on the Otters here, but the goalie was able to recover here first. Good. Aubrey McKessie, the goalie here. So number 5 is getting in here down the middle, trying to get it to her number 11 here. Number 11, Alexa Avilar. Trying to get something going here. Looks like the Otters are trying to go back to the left-hand side. Otters getting down the middle. But looks like the defense is going to smother it here. Actually, more the goalie is going to cover it. It's like a good back and forth between here. More of a battle here down the middle, if anything else. Have I seen that? Do you think that, Fred?
I would say the key player that right now, from what I can see at San Francisco, is going to be number 6, Emily Monson. She's very much controlling the middle. I would say she just needs a little bit more support once she has the ball in the middle from the forwards and possibly the outside wingers.
God. So we've got another throw in here. Number 31, passing back to number 14 here, Izzy Kolar. Looks like back to 14. 14 trying to set it down the middle, loses possession here, but a feisty trying to get it back here. Trying back to number 14 to the captain, number 5, Kirsta Kampinpin. Trying to go on the far left, now back the middle, trying to get something in the middle, and overshot.
See, that's looking very promising right now for number 9, Alin Flores. That's a very promising attempt right there, and the Gators are going to want more of that.
Yeah, it looks like Gators are trying to get at least a rebound here, but a good goal kick, good attempt at the goal. Looks like it's a goal kick here. Otters are trying to get something going. Looks like they're going to the far left side here on the wing. Number 29 trying to get the ball open here. Looks like they're going back to number 2 for the Otters. Going down the center. Center tries to get it to the right side of the wing. Number 28 gets it. Passes it to her teammate here. Trying to get something going. 28 going on the far right side on the wing here. Throwing down the middle. Trying to get something. And the good tackle, but a foul. Kind of trying to keep that on the low end here with us. The Gators have committed 165 fouls, but only have allowed 117 from the opponents. I think they should limit that overall. Do you think so?
I think it just shows the aggression that the Gators are coming in with into this game. They are trying to finish off the season with a win, especially at home. I think that just comes with the style of play that they're going with right now. It is dangerous, but it just depends on how quickly the forwards of the other team can maneuver. And if they can get those fouls, then it's going to be a problem for the Gators. But if the Gators can get it cleanly with the aggression, then, you know, it's going to be something that they can look forward to be good for them.
They're setting up here, trying to get down the kick down the middle, but loses the defense, stops it here. Trying again down the middle. Number 5 here, the captain, gets going out. Not out of danger yet, but they're trying to get something going here. Going down here, left-hand side, passes to number 11.
Alexa is doing very good of containing the ball. Unfortunately, could not get it through with 31, Samantha Shim.
Samantha loses it, but I see where the Gators were going. They were trying a lot of passing here. Good touches on both ends of the series, but Gators trying to more of a flow here overall.
Definitely would agree with you on that, Brandon. The Gators are showing more connection with their possession and passing. The Otters are trying to pick it up, but you can see the potential from the Otters. But so far, the Gators have been doing a good job of touching the ball.
There we go, back and forth. Otters can possession it, but out of bounds. Looks like it's going to be a Gator ball here. Throw in. More of a throw in here from the Gators. So they're trying to go from the right side here, but Otters pick it up. Otters trying to get something going, passing to number 22 of the Gator of the Otters, Amelia McManus, the player we were talking about, player here overall.
Oh, attempted switch, and Alexa is she's doing a good job of being in the positions that they need to be in.
Yeah, she seems to be trying to put herself in a position for teammates to get her the ball here. Looks like they're going to give a foul. Give it to out of bounds here. No foul. Foul by a guy given by the Otters. Going to try to give it here. Going to number nine here for the Gators. Alina Flores. Looks like she's trying to set something up here. What do you think? Do you think the Gators have a good chance here? Going over here to number 11, goalie keeps it in her hands safely. You know, no worries there. But number 11 here, Alexa trying to get something going. I think you're right on that. Alexa is trying to set herself up to put herself in position to at least score a goal here. Otters go a bit back here, going back to their right-hand wing, trying to get something going here.
Both teams are actually keeping their shape really well.
Looks like we got down here to the right-hand side. Yep, going out and out of bounds for the Otters.
That hustle and that pressure that the Gators are putting on all defense, mid, and forwards is going to be crucial. As we can see, that clearance is showing it right there.
Yeah, Gators here trying to end the year off on a strong start. The win, last win they've had this season was at home against Cal State East Bay, 2-0 on October 2nd. Almost 3 weeks ago since they had a win. But we're looking for another one here. Otters get it down the middle here, trying to see something set up. Number 10 for the Otters.
Rendon with a good switch right there to find the open player.
Yeah, Tiger Rendon leads the Otter with assist here, with 5 assists. Trying to get her teammates going.
One thing I can say is that the Otters' right side is looking very dangerous. They have a few players who are really driving the ball, dribbling it in, and the Gators look like they can struggle on that, and they're going to have to make sure to keep an eye on that left side.
Goal kick here over on by the goalie. Looks like it's going in a setup for number 31 here, Samantha Shim. She's going on her left side of the wing. Trying to get something going, trying to get past number 11 here for the Otters. But looks like loses it here. Going forward, getting the ball going. Looks like it's not much of a danger here as the goalie picks it up here. But kind of a threat there for the Otters, huh? Would you think so?
So right there, I think the Otters are demonstrating their counterattack ability and their fight that they're showing right there. And the Gators cannot let that continue.
Looks like they're trying to involve Amelia McManus here, the lead scorer. McManus here has been the 2023 Women's Soccer Offensive Player of the Week from October 2nd to October 8th, so about a month ago. And she's also been the 2022 CCAA All-Women's Soccer Team First Team. This is a very dangerous player the Gators are facing.
Yeah, as we can see, the flanks are what the Otters are looking to play, which is going to be the right and the left side. Majority of the right side, but you can tell that's their strength right now is those wingers.
Yeah, going for McManus here. Trying clearing it out, high ball here. Number 15 here, trying to get it. Catherine Flores. Trying to get it out to the Otters side here. Number 3 gets it. But going back to the Gators here, number 18 for the Otters, Corey Greer. Going here, trying something down the middle, trying to get something open. Number 10 trying to find an open pass here, trying to get back to her defensive player here.
I will say, Brandon, that the Otters are finding their head and finding their tempo with the possession.
Good call on that. Number 20 getting down the middle sets it that's a pass here. Going down the middle, one single person here. McManus has the ball here, trying to get it to the winger, far right side, trying to get something down the middle. Oh, dangerous. Close call. Close call by the Otters here. Almost a goal, but out of a little far to the left. What do you think on that? What do you think on that drive there?
Once again, the Otters using the flanks to their advantage. That's where all their attacks are coming from. And the defense cannot let any ball bounce in the area there. That's a very lucky moment for the Gators at this moment.
We got another corner here from the Otters here, trying to get something going again. Another kick down the middle here. Header. Goalie has it. Not much of a threat there. Trying to get her players back to the front line.
The Gators definitely have to make sure to win those headers, especially on corners and set pieces, because Otters, they're showing that they can win the ball.
All right. Another goal kick here. Get it, but the defense get it. Right back here. Number 9 passes to number 14 here. Number passes back, trying to get something going. Hits the number 8 here. 10 and Clunis. Hits her in the corner. Oh, it looks like we got a player out here. Number 11, Alexa Olivar, trying to get something going here. Kicks it. Not much going there. A little on the weak side. Goalie handles it pretty well. Passes back to her defender here. Great shot, but not a lot of power. Do you think they're trying to get more of Alexis going here for them?
Yeah, definitely. Alexa Valera is definitely going to be one of the focus points for the Gators. But I think before anything, the Gators need to really get their head calm, and they need to calm the game down and possess it as the Otters have done, because we can see the momentum shift in that aspect of the game.
Passing it back to number 20 here. It looks like they're trying to set something up here. But number 21 passes it to her teammate here on the far right side on the wing. Gets it going. Looks like we have a thorough ball here. Good pass. Kicks it over our defensive Gator. But Gator with the good defensive play here. Gets it out of bounds. Kind of a threat there. Good pass on the Otters overall.
Emily Monson showing great defense right there. A two-on-one right there? Yeah. And she manages to clear it. So Emily Monson is definitely going to need more support on that the right-hand side of the Otters.
It looks like you're right. I think the right-hand side of the Otters is going to be their biggest threat. As we go, it looks like a throw-in by the Otters. Trying to get something going here again. Trying to get something in the center. Going past it to their teammate here. Trying to go and cross in. No, she's trying to get past her thing, past the defender, but defender gets it going. Defender's trying to get past it. Not looks like slowed down, but nope. Foul here, given. Looks like we got a player down for the Gators. Not much, but looks like she's up and ready to go. Looks like we're going to have a substitution here for the Otters.
Number 4, Caden King.
Looks like number 4, Caden King. Number 8. Looks like we're another throw in here by the Otters. Otters are trying to Gators get it out.
Number 11, Alexandra Diaz.
Oh, never mind. It looks like number 11 is He's leaving the pitch. Overall, the Gators here, led by their head coach, John DeMartini, with his third season, overall record of 12 wins, 17 losses, and 8 ties. He was the CCAA Coach of the Year in 2021, and he's got managed to get the Gators into the playoffs since first time in the playoffs since 2010. While the Otters are led by their head coach, Laura Van Wart, her sixth season, but going there strong here. Looks like the Otters are getting an outside one. another out of bounds.
Gators can't seem to take control of the game right now. They're playing a lot of defense in this moment and this under their final third of the pitch.
Looks like Gators just trying to get at least the danger out of their own side of the field here. A lot of another outside here. Look at another throw in. Gets in here. Passing back to number 28. Passing after a teammate. Goes trying to forward. But Gators get the ball going. Trying to get something down the center. Throw a ball, but Gator gets it. goal. He gets it. Nice header by both teams. Looks like the Otters get it. Number 22, Mila McManus gets the ball. Trying to set up her teammate on the right-hand side on the wing. Gator gets it here. Looks like it's going to be Gator ball here. I think you're right. I believe the right-hand side is going to be the Otters' strength here. But looks like there's really a lot of pressure on the Gators here to try to stop that overall.
If we notice at the beginning of the game, the Gators were utilizing their right side, and this whole game has been played on their left side, which is the Otters' right side, which is the strong side for them.
Here we go in here, down to throw in. Looks like Otters' ball gets it. Number 29 has the ball, trying on the left side of the wing. Passes number 10 here, trying to get something going. Trying to get out of bounds here. A little late there, but, you know, out of bounds overall. Looks like the Gators got it here. I think so. You think that the Gators should move to the right side of the field for them to get their strong side going?
Yeah, definitely, but also more importantly to remember is they need to take control of the ball. There's been moments where they've looked for the through ball on the counter, which is valid in the moments that they're in, but they definitely need to control the game. Stop the ball and control the game.
Overall, let's see the Gators have it here. Good pass over, to number 14, passing it back here. Trying to get something going. 14 passes back her teammate. Passing it to her middle to her teammate. Number 14 gets the ball back. Izzy Kohler. But looks like she loses it. Passes it. Otters gets it back to player number 29 here. Cameron Burbank. Passes it to number 10. Tiger Rendon trying to get something going too. Out of bounds again.
And you can see right there what the Gators are trying to do. They're looking for the 1-2 play, and it can work. It's just in that instance, it didn't. Otters have a little bit of momentum right now.
Good defense on the Otters ball here. Gators throw in here, trying to get something past in the middle. Number 5 trying to get it, but looks like the Gators try to send it past him. Overhead. Looks like another thorough ball here. I think you're right. Yeah, looks like the Gators are just trying to get it out of their side, and not much control on the ball here. Looks like the Otters have more of a complete control over the ball here this half than the Gators do. Looks like pass here going back to number 20, Jennifer Limon, passing the ball back to number 29, Cameron Burbank. She's trying to get something through for her teammates. But looks like loses it here. Lost possession. Ball back again. Number 5 here for the Gators, trying to get something going. Casa Pinpin trying to pass. Go back. Ball goalie has it here. Goalie passes to number 29 here, Cameron Burbank again. Good Burbank here, midfielder here, freshman from Vacaville, California. She's been playing pretty good. She's more of a defensive midfielder, but was able to set up her teammates on thorough ball.
We're going to need to see more of that from what we're seeing from number 6, Emily Monson. More of that pressure and fight when the defense and has the ball in their third of the field. Talk about the East Bay. Monterey Bay.
There you go. Looks like it's a kick here. Another kick goes far to the center here. Looks like Gator balls have it. Gator's trying to get something going. Otters try to get it overall. 29 passes back to number 10, back to number 29, back to number 20. Looks like they're going to set up again to the right-hand side. Number 21. Looks like she's going to pass it to her teammate over here. Looks like they're trying to get to the right side again. Passing it to her teammate again. That's the turn of 21. 20. A lot of just sets up here. But loses it to the Gators here. Number 9. Elena Flores here gets the ball. Pass tries to get her teammate open. Yeah, Otter ball. Looks like the Gators are trying to get the ball to the right-hand side. Passing it to her teammate here. Looks like trying to get something going here. Number 6 tries to get the touch on it, but gets pushed out for a foul here. Now it looks like Looks like the ref is giving it to the Otters here. Kind of a play there. Friend, looks like the Otters are playing good defense here overall. Do you have any ideas how the Gators can maybe try to crack this defense?
They're definitely going to have to show more control on the ball instead of just lashing at it. We do see some fight from the forwards, but they don't have any support. But like I said before, it's going to come down to possession. The way they started the game is the way they should continue the game.
Oh, no. It looks like the goal kick trying to get it out of bounds. Number 4 gets it. Number 29 tries to set something up the middle. Oh, trying to get a goal here for McManus. But the goalie covers it. Not the player you want to have a ball in front of her. McManus, lead scorer for the Otters.
San Francisco needs to calm down and control the game. That's literally what it's coming down to at this moment in the half, 17 minutes ago.
Yeah, first touch on for the Gators doesn't seem that like they not a very like delicate first touch, as I would say. Is seems that it just kind of bounces off their foot and then gets a weird bounce overall. But yeah, I think you're right. I think just try to get something going here. See if they can get something going with 17 minutes left on the clock here overall.
Number 12, Kylie Johnson.
Thrown here by the Otters. Gators get it.
See, once again, we see an opportunity to take control of the game, and they're struggling. They're struggling with it. They're just clearing the ball.
That looks like a Gator ball has it here. Passes it to your teammate to the right side. Moves to the left. Passes it to your teammate, trying to get something going here. Passing it to her other teammate, number 14. Kalir. But loses it here to the Otters, number 29.
Good strength. Burbank. Good strength from Cameron right there.
You know, Cameron for being a midfielder. She's playing great defense overall here. Back to the Otters here, trying to set up to the right side again. Passing it to the middle, but loses it to the Gators. Captain here has it, trying to pass it back to someone, passing it forward. Looks like the Otters might be able to get it in control here. Number 9 gets the ball back, trying to pass something going, passing it to her teammate, number 14. Number 14 tries to set something in the middle. The goalie has complete control of it.
I think it's safe to say that San Francisco is not totally out of the game. They are creating chances. Is just going to have to be capitalizing and getting the people in the positions to capitalize on them.
Yeah, San Francisco shots on goal. They've had 60 shots on goal for the season, but they've allowed 87. Looks like we got it here to the right wing again. Out of bounds here, Otter ball again, trying to go for another throw and pass it to get to her teammate going, trying to see something, I guess trying to set something down the center again. Looks like out of bounds, but it's a Gator ball. Kind of a not really a slow half, but kind of one of those where it looks like both teams are feeling each other out. Would you say that, Fred?
I would say that they're definitely feeling each other out. San Francisco is hopefully at the half they can make adjustments. Hopefully sooner they can make adjustments to stop the control that the Otters are seeming to have on the ball.
Got a bounce here.
Good strength from the forward right there. I believe it's McManus. Yeah, it's McManus with the strength right there. She's demonstrated strength on the offensive side of the Otters.
Yeah, Tiger over here. Shot on goal here. Almost had a goal there without us noticing. Looks like it's a goal kick here. Goal kick goes. Otter ball. passes it down the middle, trying to get number 22 McManus in the offense involved here. 20 passes it, trying to get a teammate going. Number 21's nowhere near it, but the Otter defense swarms on it.
Number 20, Renee Davis, has came in with a lot of energy, and hopefully she can keep it up in the remaining 13 minutes.
Last 13 minutes here. Looks like it's Gator ball back here. Good also on their side here. Looks like a bit of a change of pace. Looks like instead of being on the Gator's side, now they're moving over to the Otter side here. Let's see if they can get something going overall. No passes to number 5 here. Throw in. That's her teammate. Get down the center. Trying to get something going, but it looks like the Otters kick it out of bounds, kick it out of the danger.
It's looking promising for San Francisco at the moment. Like I said, the chance will fall, and when it falls, they need to be ready.
It's like number 14 passes in bounds here to number 4, passes to your teammate number 8, going to the far left of the wing here. Looks like the Gators are trying to get something going, trying to throw a ball, but oh, looks like the Gators get it back. It's like, oh, trying to get a through ball here. Otter's defense stops it going.
One thing we can see is that Renee Davis coming in with so much energy, and it's showing on the field.
Yeah, she's trying to be a spark plug to the offense here. Trying to get something going. So Otter's get it here, trying to get something going again to the right wing side, but tries to get going. Booted out of the set. Number 20, Jennifer Limon, trying to get something going for her team here. Back to her teammate, number 18. Back to her teammate in front. Number 20 has it overall. Pass back to her teammate, number 21, Joanna Limon here.
We could definitely see the Otters just taking control of the game, possession-wise.
Yeah, I think you're right on this whole possession thing, is if they're taking full advantage of just having control of the ball.
Substitution for the Otters. Number 7, Jaden King. She replaces number 28, Natalia LaRue.
Now the Otters here, last time they won against San Francisco State was in October 6th of the 2022. It was a 3-1 victory. Trying to see if they can get one victory here at the end of the season. But it looks like it's been a little slow for both teams here. As for the Gators, their last win was against East Bay, as we talked before, October 12th. But last game they played, it was a 3-0 loss to Stellana State. While the Otters' last game was a loss to Chico State, 1-0 here. So both teams coming off losses, but both teams wanting to get the win here today, friend. Out of bounds here.
I think the two key players for the Otters that have been making things happen with their control and their strength on the ball is number 10 and number 22, Tiger and McManus.
Yeah, they're actually their best offensive players here, players for the Otters here. You got the lead goal scorer and the lead assist player here. I can imagine why they are. They're better players here.
Yeah, they're definitely creating stuff for the Otters. Tiger once again with a good wall pass right there.
Yeah, passing back to number 18. 18 trying to get to the winger here. Back to the right hand side. Tries to get something down the center, but the Gator defense stops it here. Getting it out of bounds. Good stop here.
That would have been a good opportunity for a counterattack for the Gators. They just could not find Davis right there. Opted for the clear instead.
Clearance. Looks like back to the Otter ball here. Back to their left-hand side. Tiger Rendon has the ball. Trying to get her teammates at a pass to the number 20. Jennifer Limon. But looks like it's Gator ball here. Looks like a foul. Foul to the Otters here. No, out of bounds? Out of bounds. Never mind. Out of bounds here.
Substitution for your Gators. Number 16, Bryn Reyes. Cheer places number 5, Carissa Kabinpin.
I think you're right. It feels like the Gators have been kind of playing more defensively than offensively this entire game. Well, the Otters have been playing more, trying to get at least a goal in here.
Yeah, the chances are going to come for both teams, as we've seen. It's just going to be a matter of who's going to capitalize on those chances.
All right, on that. Passed by the Otters in bounds here, going again to the right side of the wing. Stopped by the Gators here, trying to get passing it down the middle again here.
What a beautiful wall play right there from the Gators. Showing some promise, definitely.
Oh, number 9 has the ball. Throw a ball here. Oh, bounces off the knee. Number 31 trying to get something. Out of bounds. Kind of something. They were looking like they were getting something going there.
Definitely a little spark right there with Davis and the forwards. That's what the Gators are going to want to see more of, definitely, from their players. A little bit of that, a little bit more of that connectivity, and maybe a goal can fall.
Number 4, throw in by the Gators here. Number 14 tries to get it out of bounds. Number 16, Bryn Reyes. Looks like a substitute going on here. Number 29 going out, Cameron Burbank. Going in for number two, Jada Hardwick coming in here.
Cameron
Buback. Right. All right. Well, throw it again by the Otters. Loses it here. Back to the Gators. Another throw in by the Gators here. Far right side. Tries to get something going. Number 16 going. Number 21 tries to get a ball out of bounds again. Number 9 here.
Both teams, I can say, at this point of the half, with the final 6 minutes left, have kind of lost their head a little bit. None of them can complete more than a few passes, and that's going to be critical going on to the second half. Who can adjust it better?
Yeah, it seems like I think you're right on that. It seems like every time they get something going, either ball goes the wrong way or just bounces, you know. They just don't get the players just not there. But this is the first time about the third time where the Gators are on their side of the field trying to threat for a goal here. But loses it here. Number 14 loses it to the Otters. Out of bounds. No. Gators losing possession again here. Otters throw a ball in. Number four for the Gators just kind of kicks it. Number 20 is trying to get something going here. Sets up. There's a hard foul by the Otters, number 21. Good tackle.
It looked like it could have been a foul right there, but it looks like they're going to call a corner. Davis showing some amazing speed right there. Unfortunately, no one was in there to support her.
Yeah, trying to get something going here, but hard tackle here for the Otters here. Corner kick, number 9. Alina Flores gets it down the middle, trying to get a header in. Otters loses the ball. Number 6 here just passes. Number 4 actually for the Otters just passing it like with very good touch here. But a good tackle for our number 22 here.
The Gators did a good job of stopping McManus right there. They had 3 players on her, which they're going to have to keep doing that on those counters because she looks dangerous.
Yeah, she's the biggest scorer and threat here for the Otters here. But be a little quiet this half here, so we'll see how this. We'll see if she'd be more involved in the second half. Looks like McManus tried to center it here, but gets hit by the back of a Gator back. You're trying to get a clearance. Gators clear it out. Trying to get to number 21 here again. 21 versus 21 here, trying to get something going. Gators get the ball back. It's like trying to center the ball, but no one's around.
To be fair, Davis has came and brought energy in for the Gators. Not shifting the tide too much as both teams are fairly even, but giving more chances for the Gators.
It's true. A little more, as we said, the spark plug here. Number 20 trying to get something going. Passing it again. Oh, hard tackle here. Out of bounds.
Gator's defender is definitely making a Monterey Bay feel him right there.
Yeah, that's true. More of a football tackle than more than a soccer tackle, but out of bounds. Not going to call any foul here.
And that's what the weight room is for right there, yeah, Brandon.
True. That is true. It's out of bounds here. Looks like we're having a substitute here. Number 21 for number...
Substitution for the Otters. Number 24, Annabelle Price.
Price coming in for Limon.
Number 21, Johanna Limon.
Hey, Johanna Limon here. Good defensive presence here for the Otters, Johanna Limon. Substitute here. Looks like the last 3 minutes.
Good fight from 21 and way to keep possession right there. The Gators, this is what they're going to need more of right now in the last 3 minutes of the game, the half. Excuse me.
Burn Reyes here. Get something going. Out of bounds here.
What are your thoughts of the half so far, Brandon?
A little slow. I don't know if the definition of feeling each other out is the correct way to say it. I feel it's more or less is the Otters have been trying to get something going, but the Gators' defense is standing tall. But the Gators' offense seems to kind of be stuck in the mud here right now. It's just a lot of the passes that they're trying to get aren't going anywhere, and the players they want, you know, trying to get the players up forward, they're kind of in the back. So I feel like the adjustment is if you're going to, you know, try to win the game, get everyone pushed forward. What do you think, Efren?
I think you're absolutely right on the Gators' defense holding it down. But you know that saying, the longer you hit the wall, the more chances that it's going to fall. So the Gators are going to have to pick up something on the offense.
I agree with you there. Yeah, I think this wall may break down eventually, but we'll see how this goes. Otters passing it back to the left wing here. It looks like it's going to be a throw-in for the Gators. Number 14 throws it in to number 10. 10 passes back to her teammate. Number 18 gets it with the header, but loses it to the Gators. Passes to number 9. Number 9 passes it to her teammate, number 14. But loses it to the Otters. Try to get to number 21, but looks like there's a foul.
Once again, we see Gators trying to go with the same tactic of just launching the ball for a through ball from out of nothing. They get a couple touches, probably one or two, and then they just send it forward. Yeah. Maybe need to switch up the game plan right there.
Yeah. I think you're right. Yeah, it looks like maybe an adjustment over in the next half is probably going to get them. Maybe something like, I think you're right, goals might come in, but just an adjustment's going to have to happen soon. Good good touch, good pass. Go and get something. Ball through and lost the ball. Goalie has it here. Goalie hasn't really been faced much besides that overhead kick, but not been really threatened. And on the Gator side, the goalie has faced a few shots, but nothing too crazy.
And one minor mistake that she recovered from.
Yeah, one mistake, you're right. Yeah, so that one mistake she recovered overall. But neither goalie really seeming to be challenged this half. Looks like we're down to the last 15 seconds here. Let's see if anything keeps going.
10, 9, 8, 7.
I think starting the second half, the Gators are going to have to come out with shots. Shots. That's going to be the key term. If they're not going to touch and possess, it's going to have to be shots.
Yeah, it looks like you're right there. Yeah, we're going to have to do something there. We'll be right. We'll be back for the second half here, about 15 minutes. We'll see how this goes. I think your friend is right. We'll see how the second half goes. We'll see if there's any adjustments, and we go from there.
Today's live stream is dedicated to Herb Zettel. Thank you for everything you have done for the BECA program and many others. At this time, join us in a moment of silence.
All right, friend, pretty lackluster first half here, 0-0 over the Gators and the Otters here. What are your thoughts, analysis on the first half overall?
Fairly slow first half. Chances have been shown for both sides, but it's going to be a matter of who's going to take more shots. That's what it's going to come down to. Gator's going to have to come out with the same brick wall that they've had the first half and hopefully shut down that right side of the Otters, because the Otters have shown very lethal intentions from that right side.
If you were the Otters, what would you do different from first half? And then if you were the...
So I would say that if coming look at the Otters' point of view, one thing I would do different is get more shots and test out the keeper a little bit more. They are doing a good job of getting the ball into the box, and they're doing a good job of McManus and Tiger feeding off of their energy and control of the ball.
All right, we're going from there. We'll see how the second half goes. We'll go from there. For the second half, 0-0 here, not much going, but see if there's any changes in the second half. Our friend, what do you like, what do you don't like from the first half?
I'm gonna start off with the good before the bad. I would say that the good is gonna be both teams are showing a lot of heart and a lot of hustle. They're showing a lot of hustle and a lot of heart in winning the balls when it comes to their defensive ends. The bad, I mean, for the Gators being at home, they are lacking on that right hand side. They're doing a good job of not letting the ball go in at the moment, but and getting more shots in. Both teams need to get more shots off to the keepers, just to test out the keepers, test them out and see what they're all about. We already seen a mistake from Monterey Bay's keeper, and she hasn't been tested ever since.
All right, we'll see how this goes. We got the ball rolling here. Monterey ball. Looks like Monterey is going to go on the offensive here. Looks like they're going to the right side again, right wing. Back to the number 11. Pass to number 7 back here on the center. Back to her defender. All right, looks like we're going forward here, trying to get something going. Tiger over here has the ball, trying to set something going here. Back to her defender. Looks like ball gets past her, but Petoni's there to pick her up. Back to number 11, right-hand side, passing it to her teammate here. Back to her other teammate, back trying to get something going on the right here, right-hand side. But she's number 7's getting back to the center. Number 18 gets it, throw a ball to her. Number 11 passes to number 7 on the right side, getting it, get going. Kind of a slow, little bit slow pace here, but Gators defense stands. Good pass here, but Gator defense stops it.
It's going to be offside right there, and straight off the bat, we could see Monterey Bay coming in to look for possession. They came in looking for possession, and let's see if this is going to be their game plan for the rest of the second half.
I see the adjustments here. So possession here. Gator ball here looks going to be a goal kick. Kicking it here back to the middle. Passing it to her teammate here, trying to get something going. Throw a ball on their left wing side. Number 15 for the Raiders, Catherine Flores. Trying to get something going, but loses the ball. Otter's defense here. Tries to get the ball out of the danger zone. Gets it going, but back to the Gators here. Number 9, the captain. Tries to pass it to her teammate here. Kind of double man here to number 8. To Kylie Medlin. Looks like the Gators coming a little more aggressive than the first half here. See how this goes. Otter ball, number 20 has it. Jennifer Limon trying to set something up here, trying to get something in the center. Center ball, good pass. Tries to kick it in. Offense.
The Gators cannot let the ball bounce in their area in those set pieces. It's going to be very dangerous for the rest of the game.
Good throw pass. Passing it here, trying to get her defender off her here. Actually, good defense on the Gators here to get that ball out here on that set piece. Looks like the defense has it here again. Looks like the Otters got the ball back to the far left hand side. A pass here. Back to number to Tiger, number 10. Tiger here tries to get something going. Pass her teammate down the middle, trying to get to her teammate number 7, but gets it to her teammate number 11. Number 7 trying to set something up here, trying to get going. Number 7, Tannen Clunis, trying to get her teammates involved here. Number 20 tries to get to center, but they're headed out by number 33, Lauren Johnston, from Sonoma, California here. Looks like the Otters hit the ball here. We're trying to get something going, but looks like the Gators defense gets it, but tackle here. But looks like they're giving the ball to the Otters here. Pretty strong tackle there for on the Otters here, but Graf give it to the Otters. So what do you think on that?
The Otters are just putting pressure on the Gators right off the rip, and this not looking good for the Gators at the moment. We're just, 5 minutes into the second half?
About 5 minutes, yeah. I think that, largely said early in the first half, of keep kicking that wall, and I think we might see that wall fall soon. Looks like we got a corner kick here. Otter setting it up, trying to get something going here. What do you see here? What's the plan? What do you think overall, friend? What do you want to do here?
Definitely not let the ball bounce in the box, and it's going to be a short attempt. Gators need to win the ball if it gets crossed into the box.
Number 10 here, good kick, blocked by the Gators defense. Last defender here, but can't seem to get rid of the Otters here. Otters still in the box here. Looks like Gators trying to get a throw a ball, but goes past their man here. Otters get the ball, passes it through, trying to get something going here.
Otters are definitely demonstrating strength and communication and synchronization in the final third of the Gators.
For your Gators, number 16, Brent Reyes. Share places number 4, Emily Frey.
Looks like number 16 is coming in, Bryn Reyes for number 4. Looks like we're trying to get a little more defensive here. Like another throw in by the Gators. Gator losing number 5, gets the ball, kicks the ball out of, tries to get it out of the danger zone here. Passing it to number 18, trying to make some moves here. Number 15, Catherine Flores trying to make some moves here, but gets tripped up here. Passes to number 22. Number 8 for the Otters. 10 is Ten and Clunas trying to something on the far left wing. Tiger has the ball, trying to set something up here again. Otters have been really, really knocking on the door this time here. We might see a goal in here. Looks like a Tiger's going to take the corner here. As the Gators, are you concerned that the Otters have been kind of playing on your side of the field for at least the last 10 minutes?
I would say I'd be definitely concerned. And just as they won that header right there, first time, they're going to need to keep doing that if the Otters are going to keep knocking on that wall.
There we go. Looks like another set. Looks like the Gators trying to get out of the danger zone again.
One thing we notice is number 20 Davis is off the field for the Gators, and I would say that when she was on, there was more stuff happening on the possession wise for the Gators.
Yeah, more. I think you're right on that. More Otters playing with more possession here, with the Gators seem to kind of just trying to get it going, trying to get through more thorough balls here, but seems not to be working here. Otter ball here, passing it back to number 11 here, Alexis Diaz. Alexis out of bounds. She's trying to set something down the middle here. Kind of a threat here, but luckily he went out of bounds here. Looks like it's going to be on the Gator side of the field. We'll see if the Gators take capitalize on here, trying to see if they can get push the ball down to the goalie. Number 15 throws it in. Tries to get their teammate. Seems like the number 5 here, Carissa Kapinpin, but looks like loses it here to the Otters. Otters trying to get something going. Throw a ball to as well. Looks like Gators get it back here on the far right center. Something going on here. Looks like the ball's just barely bouncing all over the place. Looks like neither team really is trying to take advantage of these sets here or anything.
I definitely need to take advantage of all these messed up, I don't want to say messed up, but not too great of first touches from both teams. Either of them can take advantage of them, honestly. But as we see, Monterey Bay is definitely controlling the ball. They seem in sync. And they are touching the ball very nicely and recovering it once they do lose it.
Yeah, the Monterey Bay here looks like they have more control of it, as you were saying. Tiger has the ball here, kicks it to her teammate, number 22. Trying to get something going here. Threat.
Once again, we're seeing that connection with Tiger and McManus. They both are creating stuff for the team, and when they don't have options, they're swinging the ball or resetting the play, keeping possession.
The reason why they're both on the team, lead the teams in goals and assists here. kind of a threat here as we're going.
I think as a Gators mindset, they need to shut either of them up or both of them. They need to shut them down.
Done a good job so far here, but we'll see how this goes. Not a lot of pretty first touches here, but good defense overall by the Gators. Looks like foul here on the Tigers. No, on the Tigers. On the Gators by Tiger. By Tiger Rendon, I meant. Looks like it's going to be a goal kick here. Looks like the Gators got the ball back here, trying to get something going down the center. But the Otters getting it back here. I think you're right. I think the Otters just have a better kind of more of a control of the ball and a little better touch than the Gators have this entire
game.
They
are definitely looking at the simple pass rather than the launch option.
Looks like trying to get something going here. Tiger Rendon has the ball here, trying to see if she can get something going for her team. Passes it back to her defense, number three. Number three tries to get something down the middle back, trying to get Amelia more involved in this offense. Gators get the ball back, trying to pass it forward here. Gets it going. Number 31 to the right side, kicks it, and out of bounds.
Hey, some positivity shown there from the Gators, definitely with that shot. They did get a couple of touches right there, and they need to do more of that. The more they do of that, the more better chances that they're going to have to get through to the Monterey Bay's defense.
I think you're right. Yeah, I think you're right with the whole simplifying the defense and just normal touch passes. I think we'll get them far here. But we'll see how this goes. Looks like it's another goal kick by the Otters. First time in this half that the goalie's been kind of challenged, if you can call it that. But we'll see how this goes. Gators trying to get the ball here, trying to get something going. Another kick at the goalie. Goalie gets it, passing it to her teammate, number 20, on the far right side of the wing. Passes it to number 11 here, trying to pass it to number 7. 7 passes it to number 22. 22 passes it to number 11 on the right wing. 11 just getting the ball going, running through it with no problem. Puts her eyes up, sees that she gets something going. Almost a mistake by the Gators, but the goalie comes and saves it. What's your thoughts on that? The Otters kind of just came in and almost basically scored.
Right there, the Otters are showing a display of what it is to touch and move, touch and move. Touch and movement positive play once they get to the Gators half. That was very dangerous, and the defense got lucky right there on the Gator side.
Yeah, great touch passing between the teams. As you said, keeping it simple, just normal touch passes. Almost got them a goal here. Number 25 for the Gators. She's trying to get the middle, trying to get something going. Pass it to the left side, trying to get to her teammate here, number 6. But nothing here. The Otters defense stands, trying to get going. Number 22, Amelia trying to get something going here, but out of bounds. Looks like it's Otter ball still.
And you can see the Gators have the skill. They have the skill to break down this team. It's just a matter of creating combinations.
Yeah, we saw earlier with almost a goal attempt here. A lot of just touch passes between the Otters, and they almost scored there. See if the Gators can do this as well. Number 20 here for the Gators, trying to get the ball back, getting something going. Really trying to fight for this ball. Gets it on the right hand. Passes it, kicks it over, trying to get her teammate involved. Her teammate almost gets there. Gator's trying to get the ball back. Kind of a tackle, but it is Otter ball. Good attempt here.
And once again, I think the Gators, they're going to get some more energy with number 20 on the field. As soon as she came on, came with a lot of energy, a lot of hustle, and a lot of pressure on the Monterey Bay Otters whenever they have the ball. And that's going to show to create chances for the Gators, and hopefully they can capitalize.
Now speaking of number 20, looks like number 20 for the Otters is down right now. Looks like she took a kind of a bad fall there. See if we're going to see a change here. Number 20, Jennifer Limon here. Looks like she's up and going on her own power. Looks like she'll be staying in the
And she's been an anchor for the defense. She's been, you know, keeping possession whenever she has the ball and moving the play forward. It'll be a blow if she, you know, is not able to continue, but it looks like she will.
You're right on that. She is kind of a defensive anchor for the Otters. Been able to get the ball away from the Gators, and also at the same time get her team more involved in the offense here. Well, looks like we almost have something going here. Number 20 back, going to number seven trying to get something going. Passes it, gets intercepted by number 16. Passes it to number five. Number five passes it to number six. Number six is trying to get something going and tackled. Foul. Looks like we're going to give it a foul to the Gators here.
Emily Monson, number six for the Gators, has been she's been putting pressure up there on the defense, playing up top for the Gators at the moment, and proving valuable as they just won a free kick right now. Let's see if they can make something out of nothing right here.
Yeah, junior from Truckee, California here. See if the Gators will take advantage of this here. They actually have been kind of woke up. Seems like they've woken up in the last 5 minutes, and look like they want to try to score here. We'll see how that goes. See it on the kick. Got a three-man wall. See if anything they can take advantage of this. There's a go in here. Kind of a threat. Throw a ball here on the bottom, kind of far bottom corner of bottom right corner of the goal. But looks like the goalie has it. Not much of a challenge, but a good idea. What are your thoughts on that, friend?
I definitely agree with you, Brandon. Good idea to try to catch the keeper off guard. Just lacking power on that shot. But other than that, I would say good idea on trying to catch the keeper off guard right there.
Keeper hasn't really been challenged in the entire game, but good attempt there. Looks like we're going to have a substitute here. Looks like a few of the Otters are getting ready, warming up as we get a throw in for the Gators from the Gators, but the Gators get the ball back here, passing it to her teammate, passing it to the right hand side. Number 20 has it. Her teammate trying to pass it to her. Number 20 is trying to get this offense going here, as we were saying. Renee Davis, a midfielder from Folsom, California. She's kind of, as we said, the spark plug of this Gators forward here.
Definitely want to agree with you on that, Brandon. And they're going to have to keep utilizing her. She's demonstrated speed in the first half, and they're going to look to get more out of her today.
Looks like we had a corner here for the Gators. Gators trying to get down the middle here, trying to get it. Good header, but the goalie handles it no problem. That was good. A good attempt by the Gators here.
This is positive demonstration from the Gators, and more of this, and the game can switch tides. Even though it's leveled still.
Yeah, seems like the Gators have woken up a little bit more here. Looks like now they got the Otters on a little more of a defensive position. See how this goes. But, it seems like the Gators are kind of knocking on that door here, seeing if they can get something going. Maybe they get lucky in the next few, under 30 minutes, see if they can get a goal going for a win.
And number 31.
For sure, the coach is feeling the small pressure that the Gators are putting on to the Otters as they're making about a few subs here.
Trying to get some fresh legs in here, yeah, especially with 15 minutes going by. Almost an hour of running around here. So they're trying to get something going. Overall, from the first half to the second half, do you think the Gators have done better overall?
I would say they've done better in the aspect of figuring out how the Monterey Bay Otters are playing. But Monterey Bay Otters are a force to be reckoned with.
Number 22 almost gets on the score sheet. Sorry to cut you off there. Amelia McManus almost gets on the score sheet. But what were you saying there, my friend?
Definitely, just as we've seen right now, Monterey Bay is something serious for the Gators at the moment, which cannot be forgotten by the Gators, as they kind of figured out how they played, but Monterey Bay still demonstrating that they can, potentially score.
Number 25 gets to throw a ball here, trying to get it to her captain here. Number 9, Elena Flores here. Looks like the Gators waking up here a little more, trying to get something going. But the the Otters not that far from behind. Looks like they're also trying to get something going. Let's get a throw in here. Number 11 for the Otters, Alexandra Diaz, forward. Looks like it loses the ball here. Good header by the defense. No one gets it here, but looks like McManus has it. Tries to pass to her teammate, but a little behind her. Number 11 to Alexandra Diaz again.
Substitution for the Gators. Number 21, Michelle Pham. She replaces number 5, Carissa Kapinpin.
Looks like the captain going out here. Carissa Kapinpin coming out. Looks like we're going to try to get some more fresh legs here for the Gators here. So we got a... Looks like there's a throw in here. Passing it overhead. Number 9 trying to get something going here. 28 trying to pass it. Number 9 gets the ball, trying to gets past her defender here. Passing it back to her defender, but defender tries to push it forward here. Defender gets a header, but number 20 gets it here, trying to get something going, and loses the ball, Otter ball back here. Looks like to Amelia McManus here, right behind to number 11, passing it to her teammate, number 31, Lily Montesino. Looks like it's out of bounds. Looks like Otter's knocking on the door here. Looks like a corner here. No, it looks like a throw in. Overall, what do you think? How do you feel on this? How do you feel the Otters talking on this role here?
I think the Otters are definitely controlling in this half. Unfortunately, they get an offside there, but they are definitely showing a lot of promise with their communication. You can see that their communication is slightly on top of where the Gators' communication has been, at least on the attacking half.
Looks like we've got a goal kick here out of bounds by the Gators, going back to the Otters. Number 11 for the Otters, Alexandra Diaz, gets the ball here, trying to go for a throw-in. Again, going to their far right side. It looks like their strength here. Number 28 gets the ball, passes it to number 13. Number 13 passes to number 9. Looks like they're going to the other side, left-hand side. Looks like passes it to number 29, Cameron Bubank. And trying to get something going. Loses the ball, but now gains it back. But it looks like it's going to be Gator ball here. Seems like we're at a, like, kind of feels like at a standstill right now. Kind of we're seeing just ball just really more down the middle. No team's really taking it, dominating either side of the half. Well, we'll see how this goes. Looks like it's a goal kick for the Gators. Passing it here. Trying to get something going. Trying to get to number 20 here. Number 9 gets the ball. Passing it back forth. Trying to get something going here. Loses the ball. Passes number 11 here. Number 11 up.
That's going to be great recovery right there from number 8 on the Gator side, Kylie Medlin. A good way to recover her comrade right there.
Yep, almost lost the ball there, but good defensive tackling there.
Substitution.
Looks like we got another substitution
number
here.
Number 10, Haley Molinari. She replaces number 6, Emily Monson.
Looks like number 10 here. Haley Molinari is going to replace number 6 here. Emily Monson here. Looks like more fresh legs here for the Gators. Number 25 has the ball. Gators trying to fight for the ball. Gets it going, running here, trying to get something going. Passes to number 20. 20 passes it, trying to get something going, trying to get past her defenders. From the right hand side, gets her passes to defense. Back to the number 20. Number 20 tries to get something going here. Gets the ball, passes it to number 9. Number 9 gets it, trying to get to the center. Trying to center down the middle. Giving it to number 17. 17 passes, tries to get to her right wing, but the Otters get the ball back. But no, the Gators get the ball back, trying to center it here. Nothing go, but the Otter defense gets it. Otters get the ball back, trying to get a throw a ball here. Almost does. Number 13 gets the ball, passes it to number 9, but passing it back and forth. Passes it to number 28 here, back to your defender, back to 20, trying to go again back to the right side, number 11, number 20 trying to see if something can set up, back to 20 again, back to 11 on the right wing, 11 tries to get something going, and nothing much, gets the goalie, get something about the goalie here. Goalie handles it pretty well. Friend, what are your thoughts on that sequence there?
So Monterey Bay is doing a good job of attempting to get the ball forward. Limon and Diaz linking up good right there. Just unfortunately, the forwards are nowhere to be seen for the Monterey Bay at the moment. Otherwise, I'm sure we would see a goal at the moment.
Looks like we're going to get a throw-in from the Otters here. We got 20 minutes left, 0-0. Not much going on here. Monterey Bay, their best offensive weapons have been kind of shut out here. Not much of a challenge for the Gators. But looks like we almost got something going here. Number 11 trying to get something. But the goalie handles that pretty well. Goal kick here. Do you try to get your offensive players more involved with the last 20 minutes here, or do you kind of just sit here? Like, I mean, they're not like just sitting back and just passing it back and forth, but they're trying to get something going. But how do you think the Otters should involve their key players into these last 20 minutes?
I would think the key players are definitely. For the offensive movement of the Monterey Bay, they're going to have to drop down and get involved. That's going to have to be the way it's looking right now. That's going to be the only way that they're going to get involved is by dropping down as a false nine, the forwards doing that, to get the midfielders a chance to at least get a shot, even if it's from distance.
Looks like number 8 here has the ball, passing it back to her goalie. A little bit of a danger spot here. Trying to pass it and then out of bounds. For the Gators, what do you think they should do here last 20 minutes? They've also been knocking, but not as much as the Otters. But when they get a chance, what do you think the Otters should do here?
So I think at this point in the game, the Gators need to go for that clean sheet. They need to, just to end off, anything but a loss here at home would be a victory for the Gators. They got to get a shot off, no matter if it's from 20 plus yards. They just need to get shots off. The keeper looks bored for Monterey Bay.
Yep. It looks like the ball, Gators have the ball, number 20, guys, but loses to number 24 here for the Otters. But ball gets back to number. Looks like the Otters get the ball, trying to clear it out here and clear it out of bounds. Gator ball throw in. Gators throw in here, trying to go. It's number 20 has the ball, but loses it to the Otter defense here. Okay, we have the Gators here. Looks like it is out of bounds here. Looks like the Otters are trying to get a little more momentum here, trying to get something going. Looks like number 9 trying to get the ball in here. Looks like we have something here. Number 7 has the ball chance. Looks like she's passing to teammate. Looks, kicks, goal. We have a goal by the Otters. Number 28, Natalia LaRue. Scores there. Kind of, you were right there. That wall, that kicking the wall in keeps going, and the wall finally went down. Number 7 here, number Jordan Puente set up her teammate here.
So right there we see good connection from Jordan Puentes and Natalia right there, keeping a calm head once they get that cross in, and the Gators were just lost right there. Wonderful first touch finish from 28.
Great.
Natalia.
Great touch, and Tyler LaRue here gets a goal for the season from Martinez, California. Looks like the Gators have a little more pressure to try at least tie the game here. But looks like the right now with 17 minutes left, looks like we might see a loss here. But not a way you want to end the season. But just don't have time left. We'll see how this goes. Overall, that goal really wonderful. set up her teammate and just kind of let her teammate take it, let it rip. So
Puentes definitely kept a cool head in that box once receiving the ball. And the finish, I mean, what can we say? First Wonderful. Touch caught the goalie off guard.
Yeah, well, as we guys like to say, a golazo, as they say.
A golazo, definitely, Brandon. I can agree with you on that.
Good goal here, but it looks like we got time. 16 minutes left. We'll see how this goes. Okay, Otters looks like they want to lock in on the door again on the left side of the wing.
They seem to have woken up following that goal. The Otters seem to have gotten a burst of energy.
I think with any goal, I think you get a little burst of energy. You kind of want to score again here.
Definitely a confidence booster right there, Brandon.
Number 6, Emily Monson, and number 32, Cheyenne Cohen. They're place number 9, Elena Flores, and number 10, Haley Molinari.
Looks like we have some substitute with the Gators here. Looks like another throw-in by the Otters. Looks like another threat. Number 7 on the far right side of the wings. We're just waiting for her chance again. Looks like the Otters trying to set something up here. Passing it down. The Gators defense clamps down on it. Passing it to her teammate, number 8. Number 8 on the far right side falls down, but still gets her pass off. Looks like the Gators trying to get something going, but the Otters get it. Number 9 has it. Gets a pass to her defender. Passes it to a teammate. Gets it going. So out of bounds. Looks like the Gators are really just trying to get the ball out of bounds, trying to get themselves out of trouble here.
Definitely have their backs against the wall right now. As Monterey Bay is, they're just woken up. They're woken up at the moment.
As they say, waking up the sleeping beast.
Read my mind there, Brandon.
The Gators trying to get something going. Number 20 here, passing it. Number 7 has it. Gets it going. Looks like a foul happening here for the Otters. And it looks like it's going to be given to the Gators. Number 8 here, trying to get something going. Kylie Medlin. Kids that kicks it, passes it. Looks like the Otters here have it. Number 7 is getting the ball in, trying to get something going, trying to see if her teammates keep pushing it forward. So she gets it. Number 20 is right on top of her, trying to defend it. Passes it, goes for a header, almost a goal. But look, I don't know if that was the goalie blocking it or if that was just a bad header. But that was good attempt on the Otters here. Number 7 trying to set something up here. I guess she's trying to get her second assist or indoor a goal for the season here.
And the key here is that Monterey Bay is they're testing the defense and goalie, both with that cross and the finish that they had earlier. It's just showing to the point of bringing up that they have to keep taking shots and keep putting pressure on the defense and goalie.
Looks like we got a corner kick here. Pat kicks it going. Again, back it. Number 20 has it. Kicks it going. Oh, has a danger. Goalie gets it. Amelia McManus almost had another goal for the season here. San Francisco's goalie's been pretty challenging the last few minutes here. 13 minutes left. See if. See if the Gators will try to put more emphasis on the offense here or just sit back on the defense. Looks like the Otters are passing it to number 31. 31 tries to get her past her defender. Loses it here. Looks like number 2 gets it, but passing it back to your teammate. It's not really much of a danger, even though the Gators get it here and there. The Gators don't really get much. Oh, looks like the Gators got a ball here. Looks like we got a play going through, trying to get something going. We're trying to get it going, but loses it to the defense. Number 20. Jennifer Limon with the defense here. Almost had a goal there for the Gators, but the Otter defense stands tall.
It seems like Cheyenne Dohan right there couldn't get the shot off as Limon put the pressure on her. That was definitely called for to have a shot a little bit earlier.
Almost could have equalized it there. We would have had tied the game here. Got another corner for the Gators. What's your thoughts on that, friend?
I think it's fair to say that the Gators have chances. And it's not like they don't have chances. They just need to capitalize on them. And the chances are falling. There's 12 minutes left in the game, and it's possible to get goals in for the Gators.
Looks like a kind of a wasted opportunity there from the corner. Number six tries to get something going, but doesn't really get much going there. Out of bounds now. Looks like we're going to go with a throw in here.
Substitution for your Gators. Number five, Carissa Kapimpin.
Looks like we got another substitute here for the Gators here. Looks like number 25 trying to get the throw in, trying to pass it to her teammate. Again, number eight has it, kicks it down the center here, headed over, but kicked back. Looks like the Gators have it, passing it here, trying to get it to the captain here. Number nine. Number nine heads it to their teammates. Number six. Number nine has it again. Number six has it, but loses the ball. Otters just stifling here on defense. Looks like the Otters try to get something going here. Trying to get it down to the wing here. Looks like the Gators are trying to get something going here over the last 10 minutes. Any thoughts? Anything you think they could probably do, change up here?
I think that fast break attempt from the Gators that happened a few minutes ago has brought some light into the belief of the Gators, which has given them hope. And now they have to use that hope to create something.
Looks like a throw a ball here. Good pass. Trying to get something going. But looks like the referee here, the official, puts the offside flag up here. Almost another threat to the Gators here. Gators have the ball again here, trying to get it to the right side, loses it. It's like out of bounds. I think you were right earlier in the game is when had a lot of good first touches on the Gators here, but the Otters are taking advantage of it.
Pair place number nine, Jasmine Castaneda. Number 12, Kaylee Johnson. And number 31, Lily Montesinos.
All right, under 10 minutes now here. Looks like we Gators down 1-0 here with the Otters three shots on goal to the Gators one shot on goal. Otters have five corner kicks and the Gators only have four. Looks like even though it's a 1-0 game, I don't think the score really narrates what happened, what has really gone on. Looks like another threat here. The Otters lose the ball on the outside. Looks like it's going to be a goal kick. Even though it is 1-0, overall, the performance in the Gators, how do you think overall have done so far?
I think the game has been 50-50. It's just a matter of who capitalized first on their chances. Both teams have had equal amount of chances and equal amount of play in the midfield. And based off their set pieces, it's five corner kicks for the guests, Monterey Bay, and four for Gators. It just shows that the game is even. It's just a matter of who's going to test the keeper out more and who's going to, get the ball in the net.
Well, looks like the Gators here try to get something going but loses it. Looks like trying to get something going again, but this Otter defense just swarming around the Gators, not letting them do much here. Go throw a pass. It looks like number eight trying to get it. Number eight loses the ball, but it looks like the goalie has control of it. Not much of a concern, but this threat is still there. Pat goal kick here. Number passes it to number 22. 22 passes it to number 13. 13 is trying to get something on the far left wing side here. Trying to get something going. Trying to lose your defender. Passing it to your teammate here. Teammate trying to get something down the center. Trying to get something. Kicks it. And out of bounds here. Again, more of a threat for the Otters here overall. So we got another goal kick.
7 minutes left in 7 minutes left in the game. And you can see the Gators have three up top. They've switched to three up top. Three in the back.
Well, how would you describe that? Is that more of an offensive kind of a?
It's a 3-4-3. You know, they have wingers, But the wingers are going to have to definitely drop back. So they'll have. So if both wingers are doing their job and dropping back in the last 5 minutes, it'll be five in the back to prevent more goals.
So this is one of those high risk, high reward kind of formations that we have here. Okay.
Most definitely, and it's going to be a lot of work for the wingers.
Substitution for the Gators, number 9, Alina Flores.
As the Otters, do you think with the 1-0 lead right now, do you think, even though they haven't really haven't put their foot off the gas, do you just take the 1-0 win, or do you try to go for more goals with about under seven minutes left in the clock?
I say from the Otters' point of view, the smartest way to go is to keep possession and take the chance if it's there, and possession is the key.
Looks like number 9 had the ball, trying to pass their teammate, tries to kick it, but looks like a otter hits an Otter defender. Looks like we got a yellow card here. Looks like the ref is booking 20? No, I think was it booking number 20 or was he booking someone else?
I was unsure on that call.
I think it's number 20's booking on. All right, looks like number 20 is trying to get the goal kick here. Trying to get her teammates forward here. Gators get the ball, passing it back down the middle, but header to the Otters. Otters passing it forward. Number 22 trying to get involved here. Loses it to number 8. Number 8 tries to get it going. Balls through. Looks like number 33 is trying to get something going here on the right-hand side of the wing. Trying to get past her defender, but it looks like defender's just staying on top of her. Out of bounds, but still Gator ball, still put Gator possession here.
Good strength shown from Dohan right there to keep possession for their team.
Looks like the Gators are trying to get something going here, trying to get something down the center. Number 9 gets the ball back. It looks like she's trying to get around her, everyone, trying to get her teammates involved. Looks like a corner kick, almost a threat. Goalie has it. Number 20 trying to get something here. Number 20, sorry. Gator try to get it, but not much. Good attempt on the Gators, though. Goalie kicks it. Looks like a header here by the Gators. Trying to pass it to the captain. Captain passes it to her. Tries to pass it to teammate number 6, but looks like the Otters get it. Otters get it. Number 8 here passes it. Trilateral ball trying to get something going. Otter ball passes it. Kicks it. Almost a goal, but over the net and out of bounds.
Kylie Tony is doing a good job of in that moment to come out and put pressure on the forward right there, because that was a dangerous attempt right there.
Yeah, try not to let another goal in with the last 5 minutes here. Yeah, you're right. I think good attempt on the goalie Kylie Tone, trying to force the offensive the forward to try to score from where they're at. Another goal kick. Under 5 minutes left. Let's see if the Gators will put pressure on the Otter to in these last 5 minutes here. Gators passes at number 17. 17 on the tries to get going, passes to the right hand side. Try to get down the center. Otter defender gets it here. Another Gator gets it. A lot of thorough balls are trying to get, but none of their players are there to get it. Oh, it looks like we got another one here on the right hand side. Otter defender gets it out of bounds. Knocking on the door. Do you think so, friend?
Trying to knock on the door. Those through balls are not working, but it seems, last 5 minutes, last 3 minutes of the game, they have to get the ball up. So they're just doing all they can at this point. And there is a chance that something can fall, definitely. We're just going to have to see the last 3 minutes of the game.
It's going to all out salt here for the Gators, trying to get something down the center here. The cross headed up here, trying to get the ball out of danger. Looks like they're trying to get it again. Looks like the Otters get it here. But the Gators try to get the ball back. Gators do get the ball back. Number 17 has the ball. Tries to get it past the defender. Defender gets it. Otters get it. Two players collide. Looks like we got a foul here. Looks like it's the kick. 3 minutes left. Now, on the opponent's side, what would you do in this situation, Efren?
This situation, they're definitely going to have to try to dump the ball in. And Gator's priority is going to be to win the ball. Whatever ball gets hit, thrown into the box needs to get one.
It looks like we got a good goal kick. It looks like not much the goalie has to tend to. Easily handles it. But you're right. I think you're right. I think they have to win the possession and try to get the ball here and then try to get the ball forward. But not much going on here. So another goal kick. Looks like the Gators defender has it. Goalie comes out, kicks it, trying to get something going. Number 20 gets it. Jennifer Lemon has it, tries to get it going here, loses it. Oh, out of bounds.
Lemon has been proving herself on defense for the Monterey Bay right now.
Yeah, definitely a defensive stalwart here. Number 32 loses it. Out of bounds again. Gator ball. Looks like last 2 minutes here trying to get something going. Gators trying to get their offense starting, trying to not at least go down 1-0 here. Headed out of bounds, number 20 for the Otters. Another throw in here. Number 25 for the Gators here. CeCe Hallock throw in headed. Number 6 gets it here for the Gators. Emily Monson. It looks like the Otters get it back here. Number 8 has it, kicking it forward. Number 8 has trying to get it, trying to corral it, trying to get it going here. Not much going on here.
Last minutes of the game, and Monterey Bay is just, they're trying to cruise through the end. But both teams are having a hard time to keep the possession right now.
It looks like Monterey wants to score at least another goal before the end of the game. But 1 minute left, one down 1-0. This is kind of one of those games where so in the beginning, and then like you said, eventually kicking the ball to the wall. Eventually, the wall came down and goal was scored here.
We could see that with the shots on goals. We guessed here the Otters have 3 this half, and Gators only have 1. The more shots you take, the more chances of scoring you're going to have.
True. 30 seconds of the game here. Otters really just have the ball, just trying to kind of just run the clock out. I feel like they're just going to try to run the clock out, not trying to do much here unless given the opportunity. But Gators still trying to get the defense here going. Trying just to get something going, just a pass back, trying back to the number to the player, no back to number 22.
McManus just has that strength for these moments in the game.
tackle here. Gators. Well, looks like the Gators lose 1-0 to Monterey Bay, but a hard-fought battle nonetheless. Good defense by both teams. Ball came through. Friend, what are your final thoughts on this?
We got to highlight that wonderful goal by Larox, Natalia Larox. Wonderful play and a good way to capitalize on that one chance that they had. It was an even game, but the team that took the more shots in the second half ended up on top, the Otters.
I think you're right. Yeah, it looks like the Gators will drop down to it, 3-13-5. And the Gators will, and the Otters will win here, 4-8-5. What a way to end the regular season overall. Not the way you want to end the regular season, but we'll see how the next season goes. For the BECA department, BECA Media, I'd like to thank you all for joining us. Please enjoy the rest of your game. Good night, buenas noches, and shout out to my little brother Vito for the thing.